So I've got this ready aim fire kind of working, because it's amazing, because I can shoot and I can hit the target, but unfortunately my code doesn't know that I hit the target. So it seems relatively straightforward. I just want to go ahead and confirm that I've got this working, and like have it just recognize when I get close enough that we will count it. So let's dock this guy. And so I'm going to go back to this to try it out. So I know where the target's going to be. And in fact, I might even like, instead of doing a random target, I might just do a hardcore target and just set it at like 75. Just so that while I'm testing it, I'm not trying to test it with random numbers. Okay, so I've got this and I'm going to run it and I'm going to see, that's not even, you know what I'm even going to do, because why do you do that? I feel like this thing is out to get me. I'm going to dock you because you obviously can't handle the responsibility of not being on the screen. Okay, this is actually really close. I wonder where Y is right now. X. Oh, that was super smart. I'm going to pretend that didn't happen. All right, let's find the maximum value of X good bad, or good X's. Okay, so I know that I'm actually automatically hitting at 70, so let's put my target at 70 so that I know that's good. All right, so now I know I'm going to hit the target because, oh, of course, and then you don't redock. There. So I know that I'm hitting the target because I made it happen. All right, so now what I want to do is I want to see if I hit the target so I can add some logic. I can say, okay, well, if I'm within like, I don't know, 5 of the target, so I could say, so how did I do that before? Remember, I said I want to know the maximum value of the good X's, and that's how I figured out, you know, that's the maximum value that the X is going to. So I could say, all right, the, what I could do is I could say, all right, so my final X is the max of the good X's, all right? And I could say if either, let's see, how can I say this that would be super clever? I guess it doesn't matter if it's clever as long as it's good. I could say that if the final X plus 5, would that make sense? Ooh, I could do a subtraction. Absolute value, that would make sense. Okay, so I could say if the target minus the final X, if the absolute value of that is less than or equal to 5. Okay, so see if that makes sense. So basically what I'm saying, if the target was 70 and my final X is 70.1 that, then I get that. So I'm taking the absolute value of it because, say my target was 70 but my final X was, you know, 185, then technically that's less than 5, but it's because it's negative, it's really, really bad, so I'm doing an absolute value of it, because that would basically get me plus or minus on either side of it. So if the absolute value of the target minus my final is less than 5, then I'll say, you know, hit. Oh, except I can't spell. Hit. And in fact, instead of doing a display, I'm going to do a message box. I like using message boxes with the GUI because it makes it kind of obvious. It's one less thing to have to interact. So I could figure out a way to make it display on the GUI itself, but that's another step. But with the message box, I know that the message box is going to work. Okay, bam, good to go. Okay, so I'm going to do this. I mean, all I wrote was this code. I can get rid of that. All I wrote here was this code. So I'm going to add this code to the bottom of my code, or not the bottom, or wherever this plotty stuff is happening. And I also, on my target, I'm going to manually set my target to, just for a minute, I'm going to manually set my target to 70, all right? And hopefully this will work, and we'll see what happens. Okay, so 30 and 25, I think those are even the same numbers I used there. 30 and 25, okay, so I should hit it, and I should get this amazing thing, wherever it went. No, this thing. Okay, so now I go fire, and it yelled at me, and that makes me sad. I don't like it when it yells at me. What does it say? Ooh, it says that target is undefined. You're like, but it's not defined, it's defined right here. Okay, so then you gotta think about this, and you kinda think, and you think, and you get angry, and you yell, and I'm just gonna go ahead and delete these because they're bothering me. I'm gonna yell and I'm gonna scream and I'm gonna say the computer is stupid even though it's doing exactly what I told it to do. And that is, it created a variable in this function called target. But notice that it never sent it anywhere. That this function, in fact, I just deleted, or I didn't delete it. This function has no output arguments. In fact, most of these functions aren't gonna have output arguments that are created. But basically what happened was I created this function called this variable called target, and then as soon as the opening function was over, then it's like it never even happened, okay? So this is really crazy. It's like it never even happened. So what I actually need to do is I need to add a new variable to the GUI itself. And the way that I do that is through the handles structure. So I'm actually gonna say handles.target is gonna be equal to target. So instead of having just target, I'm going to specifically have a target. So if it makes sense to do this, great. If it doesn't make sense to do this, replace everywhere that you have target, replace it with handles.target. So it just kind of how you want to handle it, but basically what I'm doing is I'm saying, all right, I'm going to create a variable in the handle structure called target. And that way, since it's in the handle structure is available to everybody on the planet within this GUI thing. So I'm gonna specifically use that variable throughout. Now there's something going on here that you're not gonna know unless you're really, really paying attention. So check this out. There's this line here called update handles structure. And what that does is it basically updates this handles thing to the whole GUI. If you take this line out, then even if I make a change to handles here, it won't become permanent. It will be lost when the function is over. So I lucked out in this particular function in that this function was already doing that. But just kind of for future reference, if you've got a function that doesn't have that line, even if you think you're making changes to handles, you're not. The only way to ensure that you're making changes to handles is to end the function with this thing that says GUI data H object handles, okay? Which means now that I come down here and I have target, instead of having target, I can say go to handles, pull the target value, and go to town. So it's important to notice that all of these variables that we have in here, we have velocity, we have time, we have x, we have y, good x's, good y's, and all this kind of stuff, none of that is available outside this push button callback function, okay? And if I made a change to target, what I was trying to say earlier is the only way that I could formally make a change to handles, like if I just wanted to move the target for some reason, I'd have to put the GUI data H object handles, and I have to spell it right, I'd have to put that in there in order for that change to become permanent. So if I'm not changing anything within handles, I'm not changing specifically anything, then I don't have to worry about this. But that's kind of super ridiculous important. All right, so I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna run this. And wait, I'll get that. I'm gonna run it. And say fire, and it goes hit. This is amazing. Okay, so this actually works. This is fantastic. And I'm gonna keep it to where I'm gonna get a hit every time because I don't wanna have to be trying to find the hit while I'm testing my code. So hit! Yay, this is just very exciting because I always like it when code works because it means that, you know, I beat the computer and I win at life. Okay, so I guess what we could do, we have all kinds of options to figure out how to celebrate, I guess, whenever you get a hit. So that's something that we can think about between now and the next video.